Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to discuss about lossless joint decomposition part. Okay, so first we will see what is decomposition and why it is needed. Then we will discuss about lossless joint decomposition part and lossy joint decomposition part. Okay, and based on that we will discuss few examples. Okay, so let's start.
The process of breaking up or dividing a single relation into two or more sub-relations is called as decomposition of relation. Okay. So say suppose there is a relation R having attribute A, B, C and D. Okay. And now this relation R having some inconsistency in database or redundant data. Okay. So now we need to normalize this relational R. Okay. To remove the inconsistency in the database, we decompose this relation into R1 and R2. Okay. So say R1 is decomposed as A, B and D. And R2 is decomposed as A and C. Okay. So see here, R1 and R2 must be a subset of attributes of R, and R1 union R2 must be equals to R. Okay. So see here, a decomposition of a relation schema R consists of replacing the relation schema by two or more relation schemas that each contain a subset of attributes of R and together includes all attributes in R. Okay, means R1 union R2 must be equals to R. Okay. Now there are two types of decomposition, that is lossless joint decomposition and lossy joint decomposition. Okay, so lossless joint decomposition means there is no loss of data. Okay, so there is no loss of data in lossless joint decomposition. Okay, so if we perform the natural join operation between R1 and R2, we'll get the same relation R. Okay, and if we perform the natural join operation between R1 and R2, and if it is not equal to relation R, then we can say that it is lossy joint decomposition part. Okay, so let us discuss about lossless joint decomposition now. Lossless joint decomposition. No information is lost from the original relation during decomposition. When the sub-relations are joined back, the same relation is obtained that was decomposed. Every decomposition must always be a lossless decomposition. Okay, so this is important point. Every decomposition must always be lossless decomposition. Okay, say suppose in relation R, there is some inconsistency in data or redundant data. In order to normalize that relation R, we decompose into R1 and R2, okay? And after joining that relation R1 and R2, we should get the same relation R, which the decomposition must always be lossless, okay? So consider there is a relation R, which is decomposed into sub-relations R1, R2 till Rn, okay? So this decomposition is called lossless joint decomposition when the join of sub-relations result in the same relation R that was decomposed. Okay, means R1 union R2 equals to R. For lossless joint decomposition, R1 natural joint R2 natural joint R3 till Rn must be equals to R. Okay, if we perform the natural joint operation between decomposed relation, we should get the same relation R. Okay, so then we can say that our decomposition is lossless joint decomposition. Okay, now about lossy joint decomposition. The decomposition is called lossy joint decomposition when the join of sub-relations does not result in the same relation R that was decomposed. Means R1 union R2, R1 union R2 is not equals to R, or R1 natural join R2 is not equals to R, then we can say that our decomposition is lossy joint decomposition. The natural join of sub-relations is always found to have some extraneous tuples. Okay, so we will see with the help of examples now. Okay, so now consider this example having department table. Let's say it is D. Okay, so now this department table D is decomposed into D1 and D2. Okay, so in order to check whether this decomposition is lossless decomposition or lossy decomposition, we must perform the natural join operation between D1 and D2. Okay, it is D1, natural join operation, D2. Okay, so for natural join operation, there must be some common attribute between D1 and D2, right? So here common attribute is credit. Okay, so here you can see, if we perform the natural join operation between D1 and D2, we will get this table. Okay, means here we will get two new tuples. Okay, here you can see BSC005 MOM 8 A12 CIVIL WP. This is new tuple. BSC003 TOM 8 C12 Aerospace PA. So this is also a new tuple. So these two tuples are not there in our original table. So we can say that D1 natural join D2 is not equals to D. So our decomposition is lossy decomposition. Okay. So our decomposition is lossy decomposition. Okay. Now see here. We have considered the same table. It is same department table. Say it is D. Okay. And here. It is decomposed into D1 and D2. Okay. But in the previous example, the common attribute between D1 and D2 is credit, and here the common attribute is course ID. Okay. So now if we perform the natural join operation between D1 and D2, we will get the same result, that is D. So here D1 natural join operation D2 equals to D. So we can say that our decomposition is lossless decomposition. Okay. So from these two examples, what we can conclude, that for a lossless decomposition, D1 natural join D2 must be equals to D, or D1 union D2 equals to D. Okay. And here there must be some common attribute between decomposed relation in order to perform the natural join operation. So D1 intersection D2 should not be an empty. Okay. In previous example also, here also D1 intersection D2 is not equals to empty set. Means it is equals to credit, right? But in this example, it is equals to course ID. Okay, so what we can conclude from this, for a lossless decomposition, D1 natural join D2 must be equals to D, means D1 union D2 equals to D. D1 intersection D2 should not be equal to empty set. Okay, so we will see which are these conditions from which we can determine whether our decomposition is lossy decomposition or lossless decomposition. Okay, so see here. So now these are the conditions from which we can determine whether our decomposition is lossy decomposition or lossless decomposition. Okay, so for our decomposition to be lossless, it must satisfy the following conditions. Which are these conditions? It is R1 union R2 must be equals to R. R1 intersection R2 should not be equal to empty set, and R1 intersection R2 determines R1, or R1 intersection R2 should determine R2. If any one of these following condition is not satisfied, then we can say that our decomposition is lossy decomposition. Okay, if all the three conditions are satisfied, then our decomposition is lossless decomposition. Okay. So let us discuss few examples now. Okay, question 1. Let us consider the relation R having attribute A, B, C and D with the following functional dependency set, that is F equals to AB determine C, C determine D and B determine E. Let R be decomposed into R1 and R2. Check whether the following decomposition is lossless or lossy joint decomposition. Okay, means we have to check whether this decomposition is lossy decomposition or lossless decomposition. Okay, so let us check our first decomposition. Here R1 union R2 equals to A, B, C, D, E. Means A, B, C, D, E, which is equals to R. So our first condition is satisfied. That is R1 union R2 equals to R. Let us check for second condition. That is R1 intersection R2. So here R1 intersection R2 is empty. Means there is no common attribute between R1 and R2. So our second condition is not satisfied. Then we can say that this decomposition is lossy decomposition. Okay, so first decomposition is lossy decomposition. Now let us check for second decomposition here. Let us check our first condition, that is R1 union R2. Okay, so here A, B, C, D and E. Okay, so A, B, C, D and here E. So here R1 union R2 equals to R. So our first condition is satisfied. Okay, so let us go for second condition now, that is R1 intersection R2. Okay, so here R1 intersection R2 is common attribute is B. So R1 intersection R2 is B, which is not equals to empty set. Okay, so our second condition is also satisfied. Now R1 intersection R2 is B. Okay, so now let us check for our third condition, means R1 intersection R2 should determine R1 or R2 now. Okay, so here we get the B. Okay, from functional dependency set we can determine, let us take the closure of B. So let us consider the closure of B here. So B, so from B determines E, so we will get B E. Okay, so from this we can get R2, so it is equals to R2. So our third condition is also satisfied, that is R1 R2 determines R2. So our all the three conditions are satisfied, then we can say that our decomposition, that is R1 and R2, is lossless decomposition. Okay, I hope you understand the concept. Let us take one more example now. Okay, so next question. Consider the relation R having attribute A, B, C, D, E and G and the functional dependency set as AB determine C, AC determine B, AD determine E, B determine D, BC determine A and E determine G. Okay. Now let R be decomposed into R1 that is ABC, R2 that is ACDE and R3 that is ADG. Now we have to check whether the decomposition is lossless decomposition or lossy joint decomposition. Okay, so for that we need to check our three conditions. That is, first one is R1 union R2. So here there are three decomposed relations. So we need to check for all the three decomposed relations. That is R1 union R2 union R3. Okay, so here R1 is ABC. So from R2 is A and C is common, so that is D and E. So from R3 A and D is common, that is G. Okay, so which is our required relation, that is A, B, C, D, E and G. So our first condition is satisfied, that is R1 union R2 union R3 equals to R. So our first condition is satisfied. Now let us check for second condition, that is R1 intersection R2. Okay. So when there are more than two decomposed relations, we have to first check for R1 and R2, then R1, 2 and R3. Okay. So we will see now R1 intersection R2, which is equals to A, B, C, A, C, D. So here A and C is common between R1 and R2. Okay. So which is not equals to empty set. So our second condition is also satisfied. Now let us check for our third condition, that is R1 intersection R2 must determine R1 or R2. Okay. Okay. So here R1 intersection R2 is AC. So let us take the closure of AC now. If we take the closure of AC, so from AC we can determine B, that is A, C, B. So which is equals to our relation R1. Okay. So our third condition is also satisfied. Okay. So now all the three conditions are satisfied for R1 and R2. Okay. So now let us consider. So let R12 equals to R1 union R2, which is equals to A, B, C, D and E. Okay. So now our condition is satisfied for R1 and R2. Now let us check for R3. Okay. So for that consider R1 to intersection R3. Okay, so R12 is this A, B, C, D and E, and R3 is A, D, G. So R12 intersection R3 will give A and D. Okay, so which is not equals to empty set. So our second condition is satisfied. Okay, so now let us check for third condition, that is R12 intersection R3 must determine R12 or R3. Okay, so now let us take the closure of A, D. Okay, so here R12 intersection R3 equals to AD. So let us see whether it determines R12 or R3. Okay, so AD. Okay, so from AD we can determine E, that is ADE, and from E we can determine G, that is ADEG. If you see here ADG, which is our R3, so we can say that R12 intersection R3 determines R3. Okay, so our third condition is also satisfied. So we can say that our decomposed relation, that is R1, R2, R3 are lossless decomposition. Okay, I hope you understand the concept. So now let us see our last example, that is question 3. Now consider the relation R. Okay, so same relation, that is A, B, C, D, E, and G, and the functional dependency set. Let R be decomposed into R1, that is AB, R2, that is BC, R3, that is ABDE, and R4, that is EG. So now let us check whether the decomposition is lossless or lossy joint decomposition. Okay, so we will see our first condition, that is R1 union R2 union R3 union R4. Okay, so now we have to check for all the four decomposed relation. So R1 union R2 union R3 union R4, we will get AB from R1, BC, so that is C from R2, ABDE, so DE from R3, and E and G, so that is G from R4. So it is equals to relation R. So our first condition is satisfied. Okay, so now let us check for our second condition, that is R1 intersection R2. Okay, so R1 intersection R2 is B, so which is not equals to empty set. So our second condition is also satisfied. Okay, so now let us check for our third condition, that is R1 intersection R2. It should determine R1 or R2. Okay, so now let us take the closure of B here, that is B plus, because R1 intersection R2 equals to B. So we have to check whether it determines R1 or R2. Okay, so B plus, that is B. So from functional dependency set, yeah, B determine D, so that is BD. Okay, so AB is C, AD, B determine D. Okay, so now from BD we can determine any of this relation, that is R1 or R2. Okay, so then we can say that our third condition is not satisfied. So R1 intersection R2 cannot determine R1 or R2. So our third condition is not satisfied. So we can say that our decomposition is lossy decomposition. Okay, since it is not satisfying for our R1 and R2, then there is no need to check for R3 and R4. Okay, so decomposition will be lossy decomposition. Okay, I hope you understand the concept. Thank you.